Hey guys, Eileen Vick here for Teaching Adult Coloring with Eileen Vick. It is Thursday, May 6th at 7 p.m. Central Standard Time. Oh, good to see everybody. You know, I get excited about broadcasting and getting online and meeting everybody. Hi, Sandra. Welcome, welcome. Come on in, everybody. Good to see everybody. Always, always, always. Love it. Welcome to everybody who's coming in. Hi, Maddie. Melinda, welcome. Welcome to everybody who pops in the room. Well, thank you, Maddie. Welcome, Pearl. We are family. Ta, 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 ta. Oh, good to see everybody. Even Vicky's saying hello. I'm going to give people time to come in the door, pop in the door. We're up to 1,217 members. We are growing fast, guys. This is the place to be. All right, our Canadian contingent is here. Sandra, welcome. Ta-da. So glad to see everybody. All right, while you guys are popping in the door, have you got time to throw? Yes, Helen, you do. Okay, announcements. Hi, Melba. Oh, Amy, good to see ya. So today is, drum roll, we will be meeting and talking to Helen Elliston, who is the author of these books. She will be in shortly. It is Helen tonight. Hi, Sandra Shelley. Good to see you, sweets. Julie, welcome. Welcome to everybody who is lurking up in the balcony. Okay, guys, this Sunday, no, yes, Mother's Day. Next Sunday, May 16th, the Rose Contest ends and the Face Contest ends. If you have any questions about what those are, go into announcements and scroll down until you see them. We've got three contests running, guys. We are a busy, busy, busy group. Then, on Sunday, May 23rd, our Hearts contest ends. And actually, Helen is sponsoring that one. That is for a $100 prize, guys. You really want to be in on that one. Don't miss that. All right. And again, everything is explained in announcements. So, yeah. Alrighty, let me do something here. Yeah. All right, just had to get situated. That's right, $100 is that prize, guys. That's the Hearts Contest. And I should really call it the Loving Contest because it doesn't have to have hearts in it. Read the description. It can be any art that you want. And it needs to depict love and friendship and kindness. So whatever best depicts that. It is an Amazon gift card. It is international, which is great. Sometimes we can't do international for shipping reasons, but we try. And you have to live within an Amazon shipping area. So if you live in Timbuktu, Africa, I don't know if there's an Amazon in Timbuktu, Africa. I'll have to look it up. We can't accommodate. Okay. So for those of you that are new, this is live with Eileen Vick. I'm Eileen Vick. I broadcast every night at 7 p.m. Central Standard Time, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. Excuse me. Oh, Amazon. Oh, Dawn says Amazon is starting to print on demand for books to Australia starting March 17th, 2021. Oh, there you go. That's cool. Now, I haven't missed a broadcast yet. I don't think I've ever missed one. But I have my trusty sidekick, Dawn Boyer. And if I can't broadcast, she takes over for me. Thank you, Dawn. So I'm supposed to get my second COVID shot Monday, the 24th, and just in case I have any reaction to it, she will be pinch hitting for me. So I really appreciate that. That's right, I did miss out one for an electric power outage. You're right, I missed the one. That's right. So yeah, that is Monday, Dawn, 24th. We'll see how I feel when I'm doing that. All right. So, yay, I'm so excited. Helen is here tonight. And Helen Elliston, years and years and years of illustration background. And she is a prolific art author of coloring books. She's got a bunch of them. This is Inky Ocean that she did. I'm just going to flop through this just so that you can see. Maddie says she's all shot up. So these, I really want to do this one. So she has done this one. She's done Inky. Oh, correction on the date, launching Australia May 19th, 2021. Okay, And this is Inky Galaxy that she did. Bonsoir, Jeanette. Hello, good to see you. Merci beaucoup that you are here. So she's got some pretty nifty books. And she also, these are the ones, now these are not the only ones she does, guys, but she also has Inky Theatrical Faces. So she's got these. And again, I'm just flopping through real quick. I'm just thumbing through just to show you these. Like the mask. Fun stuff, guys. Fun stuff. Jeanette and Marsha. So, those are the books. But we are here tonight to talk about, drum roll, her newest release, Sketch and Shade. And Helen is able to be here with us tonight. I'm so excited. You know that this is the place to be for guest artists. I have them come in. To talk to us. We have a lot of fun with that. So this is the place to be. And you guys can see from the comments how everybody loves her books. Okay, Helen, so come on on. This is her newest book. And the reason that I'm showing it to you, you don't necessarily have to be a drawing person, is that I incorporate a lot of custom things into my coloring pages for you. And so when I saw this book, I thought this would be absolutely perfect. So she says, welcome to Sketch and Shade. I will help you learn how to draw with confidence using graphite pencils. Helen is a professional artist with over 30 years of experience. She is author of the Colorist Special Effects series and many more, and that's another thing. You need to see the Colorist Special Effects books that she does, where she does show how you do special effects with coloring. But she says, drawing can be daunting, but broken down into simple steps can make it so much easier and more enjoyable. Follow Helen on Facebook, which is Helen Claire Art, H-E-L-E-N. C-L-A-I-R-E art. And the website is helenclearart.co.uk. So what she says is, she says, put a blank sheet of paper under your palm to reduce smudging, and also inside this book are step-by-step guides for various images sketched and shaded. Yeah, Maddie, she's got a Facebook page. Have fun practicing and gaining the confidence to pick up a pencil and begin making marks on a page. So learn, improve, have fun, feel a sense of achievement, and then she's got copyright on it. Okay. So we need to get her in here. She should be. There we go. So So Helen, go ahead and request to get on camera and we'll get you on camera. Yep, come on in, Helen. We want Helen, we want Helen. Come on, we want Helen, we want Helen. Come on, sweetie, get in here. There we go. Hi, there you go.
This is my good side.
Oh, quit that. Put your hand down.
It's my bad side.
Well, there's some ideas there for you, maybe for drawing up some.
Make an effort and put a bit of makeup on this side. But yeah, I've not put makeup on this side because then I've got to wipe it off and then that'll get in all the scabs and not anyone wants to know that, but yeah.
It is what it is. No worries, Helen. Okay. So just as a little bit of a backstory, Helen's a little embarrassed because of this, but she, the trooper she is, she still agreed to be on camera.
Yeah. I went on a dog walk. Dogs off leave with my sister and my niece, and it was a steep slope and I was stupid enough to try and go down the slope to get my other dog to go down, and I slipped and did like a horizontal tumble. My sister thought I was gonna die. I survived, but I've just got all battered, this side, head, face, my legs, and blah blah. So I've just had literally a week of just feeling sorry for myself, but I've survived.
That's right, you're right, and you're fine, and we're so glad that you're here. Thank you
so but much. No, look at me that side, and I don't look too bad.
Okay, well, I'll tell you what, I'm sure everybody here will promise not to look at your bad side. We'll just look at your good side. So,
but it's funny because bruising, it's just got, it was there, then there, and it just dropped down. It's every day it changes. It's dropped down and down. And now it's down here. I didn't even bash this bit.
Yeah. Well, you're fine. You're fine. You're just a little worse than the wear.
Yeah.
When you survive. That's right. Okay. So Helen. We are introducing the book. She's here to talk about this book, and this is called The Sketch and Shade and Much More, and I read the introduction to everybody. So what it is she also goes through and shows all the stuff that you need. Basically, she's working with graphite pencil. That is a softer pencil. It's a 2B or a 10B. You want your kneadable eraser. You've got a thin nibbed eraser, cotton wool balls or pads, or cotton, tissue paper, or toilet roll. Okay, now, and white paper to draw on. So one of the things that I like to do in my coloring books is add images to pages. And so I thought this book was really neat. And you guys, let me, you know, make sure that I'm centered on camera here. One of the things that I like to do is, you know, again, I customize pages. And so what I want to show everybody, number one, we wanted to meet you, Helen.
I remember the first time I knew you, Eileen, you did a thing, space, it was one of my dogs, and you did,
right.
Now, do you remember?
I absolutely do remember.
That's the first time I knew of you.
Yeah. I cut out one of the, I traced one of the images that Helen had of her dog, and I took it from one page.
Face helmet, and my dog in the helmet, yes.
Exactly, exactly. That's exactly what I did. And that's how Helen and I met, and she liked my work, and we've just been in touch ever since. So her book here goes into the basics of all that you're going to need to know with your graphite pencils. These are all the different ones you have. Now, having said that, everybody, what I'm doing, going to do here is I'm going to show you a couple things, and I'm going to be paging through the book. But Helen, if you're on my site, or not Helen, but
I'm Helen here.
Helen put a video together showing the how to smudge in a background.
Oh, I did it a few hours ago.
Yes, you did, and I posted that in my group. And the main thing that I want to show you now is I'm going to grab a couple of images from this book, and I'm going to show you. Now, I am not an illustrator, and I'm not a drawing artist, but I want to show you how straightforward this is, because she breaks it down beautifully into different steps.
Well, I hope I do.
So, really, all you need to do, and one of the things that I would recommend, is if you are doing this for your coloring books, is just to do a smaller version of what Helen shows you. So see how I'm making this little filigree?
Yeah.
And did you see my thing about tracing a window with the sun coming through if you don't have a light box?
That's right. So you can trace these. And the really neat thing about this is, and again, I'm just doing this by eyeball here. Yeah. Okay. So let me add a little doohickey here. Okay. And then I'm going
to form, by the way,
come through. And then I'm going to close this off. Hi, sweetie, the cute dog. So here's an example now of how you can add your own filigree. Now, you can also, this paper is thin enough, you can also trace this. And the really neat thing about that is that will... That will show you.
Stop it. Sorry about that. They're getting jealous. Boy, stop it. Mommy's not happy. Sorry about that.
No problem.
They get a bit jealous who's the alpha male, and I have to remind them that I'm in charge.
Okay, so what I'm doing now is I'm just going through and I am tracing the image from Helen's book. So what that does, guys, is that...
But also, can I just say, some people might find it hard to trace on a page. You could also use a piece of tracing paper and then trace. Do you know what I mean, Eileen? You'll know what I mean.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Okay, so see, this is what I want to show you guys, is I want you to see in Helen's book how straightforward this is.
And please stop it. Stop it. And
even if you are a beginner to drawing, this book is absolutely perfect for this. So she's done very basic, and then what she does is she gives you a page here that says copy, sketch, and play, and it shows you all the different ways that you can go ahead. And
well, my dogs aren't obviously geared up for beetle.
That's all right. All right. So we've also got here an image on how you want to do your ribbon, and I'm going to pull this all together in a minute, guys. I just want to show you this. And she just shows the
basic things that you need to do these images.
Yeah, because with a simple ribbon, it's where to put the flow beneath.
Yeah, the wider it, part of the ribbon. Yeah, and then here is the she also shades it, but she also shows you the line art on how to do this. So this is the main thing of the book, and if you keep practicing, these are the types of things that you can do for yourself. All right. And again, I'm just showing you that when she starts her lines, so we're going to go and do like a little banner here. And again, the reason that I'm doing this now is I want you to see how easy it is to put this stuff together. Okay. So here are the lines to do a banner. And then I'll just go ahead and extend that and put a little break in it and bring it back.
Yeah, well, that's the thing I tried to do, that people could do a V shape on it and they could do more squiggle things, but hopefully understand the down lines.
Uh-huh. Okay, now, here's a really easy piece to do, and I wanted to grab this one because I'm going to show you on an image what I'm thinking about for coloring books. So here are, again, she shows you how to do the basic shape. Okay, so here's a scroll, and we're going to bring this down and bring this down. And there you go, getting
hi, Monty.
Okay. And then when you finish this off, we'll go ahead and round that on the bottom. And then you're going to do an upside down curve. Now, again, these are so straightforward. Let me do one more real quick. So I'm going to go like this and like this, right?
You might need to go across because my face is in the way.
No. Okay. Guys, tell me if I need to move over, please. Okay. See, we're just doing very simple, straightforward lines.
That's better. And then the under curve.
And then we'll do it. Yeah.
Yeah, perfect.
Yeah. Now,
and
again,
that can be any curve amount of shape. And then the other ones I've done is the old scroll. What words am I thinking of?
You'll get there, I know.
Yeah, you know what I mean, don't you? I can't think of the word right now. Crusted, what am I on about?
I'm not sure.
Well, you know what I mean? The rusty, not rusty. God, why?
Take your time. Let me know when you think of it. Okay.
Well, so old scroll, bitten, chewed, burnt. What am I thinking of?
Pirate scrolls or Bible
scrolls? Yeah, yeah. Or where it's all like jagged on edges and...
Oh yeah, like to have it burned and stuff like that. Exactly.
Yeah, that's okay. I can't think of the word.
Okay.
It's my head. But I have my head bang, so maybe I can't think of words anymore.
Now, I want to show you parchment, antique parchment. Is that what you're thinking of?
Antique
parchment. Okay. All right. Now, let me show you where this will apply. All right. Can you see her image, everybody, or is it cut off? Somebody needs to tell me this, because I always can't
tell.
I can
see it.
Okay, can you see it now?
No, I can't see the coloring girl pirate.
Okay, all right. Okay, so here's what I want to show
you.
Maybe
if you zoom out, if you want to have more of your... I can see the pirate as a full A4 thing.
Okay, I just want to make sure... Yeah, I just want to make sure on the screen where we're seeing this. Okay, so here's the example of the scroll that I just did. So this is from the coloring book Pirates. So here's an example now of how to apply this. And then we're going to talk to Helen and find out more about her. So I'm just going to do a little, I just want to do a little angle here and come up and come over. Okay. And then I'm going to bring the line down. See how I'm just curving that in, and you can see that line and seeing the scroll come up. And then I'm going to do the little smiley face on the bottom. And then we'll do the back line. So here's my point. If you have an image like this and you want to go ahead and add embellishments to it, this would be the way to do it.
That's an easy shape to do once you know how to do.
Right.
And then, yeah.
And again, I have not done this before, and this is why you do this in pencil.
Curly whirly.
Yes. But once you see the image and once you get the general idea of it, so you come out down with your two lines, curve that in a little bit, curve that in a little bit.
And then if the inner curl is more, then you do a down line on the inner.
Uh-huh.
Do you know what I mean, Eileen?
Okay, so what? Do this and then
right,
what
the inner curl. The inner curl at the top.
Okay, so add one at the top?
Yeah, the inner curl, if that goes a bit more round, the inner, right, go to the right, no, the inner top curl,
okay.
If that curled a bit more round, then you'd have a down line of the start of the dude loofer, of the, I'm sorry, dude loofer, I'm from York, Cheshire and Yorkshire. The top of the curl.
Okay.
No, yeah, go down, left, up, that top little bit of curl.
Oh, right here, okay.
So that would have a down line.
Oh, okay, yeah.
That's what I mean. And the other side would have a down line where it's curled round. Does that make sense?
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, that'd have a down line.
Okay.
I suppose, I don't know, but that's what I call a downline.
Okay. And again, guys, when you do stuff like this, this is, you know, you're playing with it, you're doing it in pencil. But the point is now, too, is that you can go ahead and... Yeah, I gotcha.
Do you see what I mean? And then if people want, they can do the jagged thing to make it old...
Weather. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, there you go. Okay. See how I did that down line right there?
Yes. Yes.
And that makes it look perfect. Like a piece of paper. There you go. That's what we want. Okay. So let me come in with that a little bit. So see, you've even got a fancier curl on that. Okay.
Yeah. And people can do, you can do a more curl if people want to.
Uh-huh. Now, if you wanted to, you could also add a little script on that. I mean, just whatever you want to do. Now, let me show you what Helen was talking about as well. If you want to make this look more piratey, is
that's
you go
the
ahead.
Word. Piratey, I suppose. Yeah,
piratey,
yeah.
That's my word. And you just make the edge ragged. And like we're going to tear away pieces on this. And then you can go ahead and shade this. So there are all sorts of little embellishments now that you can add to these things to make it look like your piece of paper. So can everybody see now how I'm going ahead and making it look like that page is ripped?
That's the word, ripped. There's so many words for different things, and
We'll go ahead and put a little hole in here on the side.
I've done things before, Eileen, where, you know, where you get a piece of paper and a tea bag.
Okay.
And stain paper.
Uh-huh.
And then I'm not saying anyone should do this because it's a fire hazard and so on, but then light round the edge.
Yes.
To make it the old burnt. I'm not recommending that anyone. I'm not going to be blamed if anyone burns the house down, but you know what I mean, do you?
Absolutely, yeah. Okay, so everybody see that. So now we're adding on the bottom, or on this whole piece, is you can add little, you know, I could add multiple pirate maps on this to make this image now look like more of the pirate. And that's the point of this book that I want to make, is you can do these things now because Helen's book walks you through these very basic images. Now, her next page, by the way, happens to be a scroll. And that's a horizontal scroll. And if you look through here, these are the exact steps on how to do that. So it will show you. I mean, guys, I really am drawing challenged. It will show you. You just make a little wonky six here. Okay. And you can curl that a little bit more if you like. And then go through, you just...
Who said, oh, well, the owl?
I'm sorry?
Who said, oh, well, the owl? I'm Sherry.
Well, oh, okay.
This is the owl I drew. An ornament.
Oh, there you go. So she shows you exactly now how to make this. So I want you to see her image and my image, and then you just angle this back in a little bit and come over and make a sideways smiley. There's the scroll. All right. And if you, and what she did too, is she made the little dip lines in it and erased it to make the little scraggly lines.
That's it. Make the dips. And then if you want it, then you erase the dippy.
Exactly. Yeah.
Exactly, Kylie. You're completely correct. Yeah.
Uh-huh. So, and that's why you want to have one of these little erasers by Tombow. Wrong one. It's this one here. And then you just erase the part that you don't want. And then you'll go back. Now, let me show you. Now, you guys know that I love my pens, right? And then you go back and you take your black pen, which is what I use. Let me pull you in. And go ahead and ink that line. And the way that you choose your pen weight is based on how heavy the lines are in your coloring book. This happens to be the heaviest one. All right. So I've inked that. Now I'm going to show you real quick. I'll tell you what, I got to let that dry. So we'll let that dry a minute. But I want you to see how easy these images are to use and to adapt. Here's the outline for the owl that she did. You can trace those. Yeah. You can trace those as well. So these are very, very nice images. She walks you all the way through how to do this. Here's a cute little bird that you can do. So there are all the images for that. And again, I'm just picking now, just real quick, glowing candle. And here's a rose. If you guys were wondering how to draw a rose, which I will attempt that in a minute after I show you what I'm doing with this scroll. All right, let's go back to the scroll now that my ink is dried.
Yeah, because, yeah, you've got to let ink dry, otherwise, it's going to smudge.
That's right. All right, but I want to show you the complete steps using Helen's book to do this. So now I'm just going to very lightly take my eraser and erase off. Ah, it's going to smudge a little bit. That's all right.
Oh, well.
I'm going to erase my pencil line.
Adds to the feel of it.
There you go. That's right. All right. And then, so let's think about our little pirate girl that we had that I just showed you a minute ago. And then I'm going to go through, I'm going to grab my brown and color this up. And then I'm going to shade that with a slightly darker brown. Can everybody see now how really cool this is turning out?
That's looking lovely. Yeah, Authentic.
Uh-huh. Look at that, guys. And then I'm going to take a little bit of black and I'll smudge that up a little bit, dirty it up.
That's the thing with the dirty it up with the old scrolly thing and some cracks and line cracks and things like that.
There you go. So that's what I wanted to show you is by drawing your own image now, you can go ahead and draw that sort of thing on your, hold on, let me tear my page. Hold on. Quick impromptu lesson here is that you can go ahead and add your scroll that you've drawn on the page onto your coloring page. Does that make sense to everybody? So see, this is why Helen's book is so versatile, that you can do these types of things. So I just tore that out to show you where.
Hopefully it helps people to be confident more to try drawing, but also confident more to add to and color things in and draw their own things and color, you know, and helps with the light and shade.
Right. And guys, this is the beautiful companion book to Helen's book, The Colorist's Effects, that she did. Okay, see how I'm starting to do this rose now? So we'll go with this line and bring that out and around. Make a little divot there. And I'm just going to bring it in like this. Now see, you can draw your own center. But see, this is...
Yeah. And that's it, Eileen, exactly. And then it's just people knowing to do the down lines to...
Right. And what Helen is talking about, guys, when she's talking about down lines and doing that sort of thing, is when you've got the curl and you're moving this around, let me make it like that, the down line is that straight down line here. And that starts to what gives you your dimension. Yeah. Okay? All right. So there's the example. And her book. book now, and then she takes you through all the steps and takes you through all the shading of the items. Now, keep in mind that this particular book.
I'm back. Hold on.
Okay, take your time.
Carry on. No, I'm just.
This particular book is really great for the sketching. And when she's talking about the shading as well, then that's where your coloring effects and shading are going to come in, like I did with my little scroll. Okay? Does that make sense to everybody? So we've got the different size roses. And the other nice thing about this book too is you can trace off of it. And then where Helen is shading, that's where you're going to color in. So when she's doing the shading, think of it, here's a great way. Think of this as grayscale, guys. And this is where you're going to emphasize your coloring and your highlighting.
Yeah, I tried to do a variation of how to draw in lines, yeah?
Yeah.
And then also how to, once I've drawn it in lines, how to shade it step by step by step. I try to get a balance in the book.
Okay, good. And again, that's the important part. And the reason that I really like this book is that the steps are so clear. You know, when you're doing something like this daisy, and again, this is the first time I'm doing this, so bear with me. But you can go ahead if you want and add your little dashed lines. This is why you do this in pencil. And then you go ahead and add your components. Whoop. So I've just got two there. That's okay.
But that's all right if they're not perfect, they're mixed and matched. And if you look on the next page, Eileen, I've done some things of how to do, well, on this page, I've done things of how to do the center to make it look more bulbous. On the next page, I've done the petals of how to make them a bit more exciting and flip, you know, folded, flip.
Exactly.
Because sometimes coloring books, I've done it myself, it's just flat flowers. So
yes.
I wanted to try and show people how to draw something that's, you know, a curled, twisted leaf and flower. I've got leaves in there in the book as well that's twisted leaves and.
Yeah, and I'm going to show that. And guys, that's a really good point because I want to show you this. So I'm going to zoom you in just a little bit.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Instead, just flat. You know what I mean, Eileen, don't you?
Yep, I know exactly what you mean. All right, so I'm going to make my little plus in there. Again, these are the pencil lines, so you'll be erasing these. All right, so go ahead and do your flower. I really want you guys to see how straightforward this is. And as Helen said, don't worry about perfect. We're not doing perfect. We're doing a flower right now.
Okay. I think perfect is, sometimes perfect's a bit boring.
It is. Now, what I want to show you is I'm going to pick one of these leaves or petals, and I'm going to draw a downward curve right here.
Yeah, I see already that's looking folded over. Yeah.
Yeah, see how that's looking folded over, guys? And when you draw that downward curve, you can also draw it off to the side a little bit.
I mean, that just means that the original petal would be longer to curl over. Do you know what I mean?
We can do that. Make a real long one here.
So that's something that you do, and then a raise to make, yeah.
Yeah, and then you just do your fold over right here.
You can make. Yeah, but I'm saying the fold over there makes it, it would be even longer.
Uh-huh.
So you do the fold over in a shorter petal.
That's right.
Yeah.
All right. And again, it works beautifully, guys.
But it's the idea of it. That's...
Yep. All right. Now, one of the things too that I do when I'm learning a new technique, for example, in Helen's book, and this is just standard copy paper, is in this particular instance, I would go ahead and trace this. And then that way that gives my hand the what's called movement memory to show me what I need to do to make that particular look. All right. So Helen shows this on her shaded daisies. So here's where these pages are here. She shows you the shading. And again, guys, think grayscale.
Okay? Yeah, I like the curled over. It just makes a daisy or any flower or any leaf more fun.
Uh-huh. So if I were drawing this, and then my fold over is going to be here, down towards my center. This will be my center right here. And again, guys, very, very rough here. As you can see how these leaves now are folding over each other, or petals, excuse me, petals. And then you just go ahead and erase out.
But the fold overs, the main, you need to have that line in it.
Yeah.
The shadow line in the bit for the fold.
That's right.
That's the main bit. If I explained it right.
You did. All right, so now you'll see that fold over on that. And this, of course, I will refine with eraser and pencil, but you can see that image now. And here's my point. As we're working on our coloring books, guys, these are all things that we could go ahead and add little add-ons to our pages, just like I did with the pirate scroll. Very straightforward. So here she's got how to do a daffodil.
Yeah, this is a daffodil I had in my house and I took a photo of last summer.
Yeah. All right, so here's a, also she was talking about the curled leaf sketches. Let's see if I can pull that up real quick.
Is it okay if I go to the toilet?
Of course. So what I'm doing here, I'm surprised she didn't say Lou. So here we've got the underside of our leaf. And then notice where she puts the dashed lines so you can see this exactly. She puts in not only what you're drawing, but what you're going to be drawing. Okay, everybody see that? Now we've got a beautiful folded over leaf, all right? And then we'll do our line down the center here. And we can do a little bit of a stem if we like. Look how cool that looks, guys. And then, same as I did with my pirate scroll.
Hi.
Hey there. You can go ahead and ink that in. I just skipped that for time's sake.
I'll get you a treat if you're nice.
And then we're going to go ahead and blend that in.
Well, that's looking good.
Now, guys, I got to tell you.
I do like, because a lot of coloring books, some do, some don't, whatever. But a lot of people, it's flat leaves. Do you know what I mean, Eileen? And I just like the idea of people learning how to do a twisted.
I agree with you. Now, and then, of course, I would have inked that in. But the thing that I want to show you guys is that this book opens up a lot of opportunity for doing different kinds of leaves in
your
book.
Listening. I'm just going to get them a treat to show.
Okay. Okay, so on this leaf, for example, here, we're just going to draw the oval, and then you're going to draw the curl right there. Look how simple that is, guys. And then, if you want to, on these leaves, you can go ahead and draw your oval like a teardrop. It's a sideways teardrop. And then you can make that part of a leaf come way down. And even if you want to come out a little bit and just erase your line. So if you're going to add, let me go, if you're going to add elements to your pages, this is the way to do it. Here's another sample here, is make your teardrop, and then you bring your line down and curl it like this.
Yeah, and curl a bit more.
And then I'm just going to make that bumpy and erase the part that I don't want.
You've done good there, Eileen. Yeah.
Well done. It's not too
bad. High five.
Yeah. Here you go.
High five.
Okay. So everybody see now how I've gone ahead and made, and you can adjust and adjust and adjust, and then just ink in your final image. So you don't have to worry about at all how this is going to turn out from the standpoint, because you've got your erasing. All right, let me do one quick one here again. So I'm going to make my long leaf, okay? And then I'm going to make my top part. So I'm adding here. I'm going to go here. Let me make sure I'm on the page here. And come up. And go back here. Okay.
So I was just trying to see some of the comments. I can't see because of the white page on your side. I can't see the, you know what I mean? I can't see the word. But hello, everyone, even if I can't see what you're saying.
And then just go ahead and adjust your page as need be. All right, see how I'm doing that? There's your leaf.
Yeah, super.
And then, again, go back in. And I'm just doing like super quick coloring.
Oh, I can see Matty. Hi, Matty.
And then just go ahead and shade in that you would, you know, your parts that you would shade in. And you've got yourself your leaf. Okay, so let me see something here. Let's see.
I'm painted just... nails especially for tonight, Eileen.
Oh, you did? Okay.
I did.
Looking pretty. All right. So this is what I wanted to show you guys. Now, let me pull out here.
I'm having fun.
And here, on here, we've got several pages now of showing the different curled leaves and the steps to do it. And here is how you shadow.
Yeah, and notice there, I did, it's not obvious, but there's a gap under the leaf to show that the light, if you go up.
Right there. Yeah,
to show the light coming through because it's a raised crispy leaf.
Right.
Yeah, you know what I mean, don't you?
Yeah,
the light's coming through it.
Perfect.
And I've done that. There's a few things where light comes through and.
Okay, now here's what she's calling a laurel leaf.
Yeah, I took a photo of that on a walk or whatever, and yeah.
Yeah, and she's taking the steps all the way from making the laurel leaf itself down.
Yeah, through. So you could either draw that as a. If you want to just draw it as a leaf leaf or draw it as a complete shaded leaf.
Uh-huh. Okay, so let me okay.
But if anyone's got any questions, they can ask me. I'm not necessarily seeing them, but they can ask me.
Okay. All right. Yeah, this is more, let's see. Oh, and guys, by the way, I will be putting the link up for this book. All right. So I want to show you a really quick way to do this cushion because that's a neat piece as well. All right.
Yeah. Cushion's actually really easy. Once you know, and it's broken into the simple
exactly
steps.
Now see how
it's all in really the smudging and then some darker pencil creases.
Yes, and see I curved in these little lines. See how I made the little U's. And then what you do is you make your little crease line.
Sorry, everybody, but I do vape. Sorry.
On the pillow. I think, well, Helen, what I'm going to do is this, is after I demonstrate some of these images, I will put a darker background on the text so people can ask you questions.
Yeah. What do you mean? Oh, I see. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because it's light on your side.
Yeah.
Whereas if I was on that side and you were on this side. Yes, I see what you mean. Yeah.
So give me a minute here because I just wanted to demonstrate.
That's all right.
All right.
So if I look, I can see on some.
Okay. Okay, now everybody.
But yeah, I see what you mean. Yeah.
Everybody
yeah,
see how I'm just adding these little smudges on here now to indicate the folds of the pillow?
And then this is after stuff where I've said my really okay. Useful.
All right. Now, again, I don't mean to here. Let me use a different color. And again, guys, I will have the affiliate list up for this book. So I'm going to color this a light blue. And again, I would have inked this with a pen.
My thing is always that, I mean, I've got some tips within the book, a couple of pages of tips within the book, that squint your eyes, and that helps you to see the light versus the dark. And also, if you're copying something, turn it upside down, and then you don't see the image you're doing, you just see the light, dark, and lines. And does that make sense, Eileen?
Yeah, it sure does. All right, everybody see how I drew that cushion now? And if you want to, you can change the overall shape of this cushion. Let me just take a quick peek on something here.
But I do more shading around the edges, and then I do more erasing in the middle. But yeah, I know it's just a quick demo. Yeah,
I mean, you can curve this in to make it curved. All right, let me just look up something real quick.
What does everyone think of my book so far? Who's watching things?
Let me move this so I can.
Let's see what people think of book so far.
Yep, there we go. So what do you guys think so far?
I don't think it is up yet. I don't know what that means. That's Sandra. I don't think it is up yet. Matty, we are getting it. Helen. Sherry says love, love. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Looks great, gotta get it. Oh, thank you. Well, hopefully people, you know, get something out of it, fun, and learn and get a inspiration and a thing to wanna, you know, draw and stuff. It's, you know, we all have a fun to colour, but also some people like to the idea of trying to sketch and draw, but also with my book you can draw stuff, but then after you've drawn it, you can colour it in. So
yeah, exactly. And actually, guys, it is in the affiliate link, but I'm pulling it right now, and I'm going ahead and I'm posting it on the main page. So we'll get that in there. Okay, from tonight's.
Oh, thank you, Sherry. Thank you. I've enjoyed. I've been working on this book since August. So it's literally my lockdown year book.
All right, let me show you a couple more things and then let's have a major chat with Helen here. So
you take control, Eileen. I know I go on and on sometimes.
Oh no, listen, this is what we love about our artists, is to talk to them and, you know, find out about them.
Oh, do you show the soapy bubbles on the next one, the finish of the soap bar? Because I'm really proud of that, the soapy bubbly bits.
Oh, right here? Yeah.
Yeah. And that's all like a little eraser, a soapy bubbly erasing. I'm proud of that.
Yeah, look how those bubbles come through. That's absolutely gorgeous.
You know, little erasery soapy bubbles. Yeah.
And guys, that's the really neat thing about this book, is that it shows you these little details, and these are perfectly translatable into what you're doing for your coloring books. You know, we've all done images that have the French braid on the hair, and she covers how to do that as well.
My friend plaited her daughter's hair.
And if you look at that on a white piece of paper now, it's just a matter of making these little V's here. See how I'm moving that with my pencil? And you just draw your line, and then you start making this on the side, and you can end up coloring something in like that. And here's another, like a chain link fence. Now this, guys, would be really cool if you wanted to make a background on your page.
That's exactly what I thought, Eileen, by doing it, a nice background.
In fact, I may even do that on one of these coloring books that I'm doing it. Okay, Sarah, did you find the affiliate link? I put it up. Sarah says she just ordered the book, Helen. So,
thank you, sweetie.
Lots and lots of beautiful images here. Now, some of these are a little more complex, but as you practice with them, you will be just fine. If you go through and attack the ones that you know, here's a great way how to do a silver bell. So beautiful, beautiful. Here's a nice walkthrough on how to do a stack of stones. Now, this, guys, would be really terrific to add on the.
Yeah, my brother-in-law took that photo and stacked them up and took them. And I tried in that description to show the eye line of the ones, you know what I mean, don't you, Eileen?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Ones above ones, and that's the eye line. So those are a bit more, I can't think of the words. I think the knock to my head's made me gone funny. But yeah, it's the central eye line.
Okay.
And then those are...
Okay, so in other words, what I believe Helen is saying, you've got your eye line right here and you've got your stones above and below, and you're just gonna go ahead and shade accordingly. So that gives you that concept. The really neat thing about this, and what you're calling the eye line is the horizon, actually.
Yes.
So when you are doing these stones, guys, all you're doing is so straightforward. I want you to see this. You're literally just making your ovals, you see? And so you make your ovals and you stack them on top of each other here. So you'll drop this line a little below that one. So you just decide which stone is on top of what stone. And then you're just gonna go ahead and do your shading on this. This would be very straightforward. And you could add this as a beautiful background on your coloring books as an extra element. So that really, guys, I'm just flipping through the book. Again, some of these are a little more involved than other, but if you walk through it and do it, here's how to do some matchsticks. And then you can go ahead and shade those. Very, very straightforward. The directions are very clear. How to do a pin cushion. How to do a soap dispenser, tissue box. I mean, just all sorts of neat little things here. All right. So this is the Sketch and Shade by Helen Elliston. Let me pull you out. There we go. All right. So does anybody have any questions for Helen? So Helen, how did you get into your drawing and artwork and everything that you're doing?
I've been an artist and doing art since I was able to walk.
Okay.
That was always the only thing I ever wanted to do art and stuff. I did art at school, in primary school. I did art at second school, then I went to art college, then I went to university and did art, different forms of art, but that's the only thing that I ever wanted to do.
Okay, now Maddie wanted to know, okay, do you have a PDF of this book or is it hard copy only?
No, it's paperback only.
Okay, paperback only. All right. And there's a little bit about perspective here, about how to do that. Maddie wanted to know about that. So she doesn't go a lot into talking about perspective, but she does add.
But I've tried to explain on some of the pages a grid method.
Okay.
I haven't done it on all the pages because I thought that people might, well, get bored of me explaining it on every page.
Okay.
But take the idea of one grid method page and maybe be, they might be able to apply it to themselves.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and a question came up. How do you feel about an artist glove? Do you know what that is, the artist glove? Have you ever used an artist glove? It's a glove that you put on and then you wear it and it keeps the page from smudging because it covers your
I tend to use a piece of paper under my palm. But yeah, I'm not against an artist glove, but yeah, I just have a piece of paper under my palm. I suppose that allows me, I mean, if I had a glove on, I don't know, if I went to get something from the fridge or patted my dog, or I don't know, would I have to take the glove on and off? And
okay, so you do what I do. I use the tissue. I use a paper
towel.
Yeah,
basically, yeah.
Okay, now question: will there ever be a PDF of this book? I want my friend in New Zealand to have this.
I'm not sure. When you do a PDF of something, people can, I might be completely wrong in this, but people can pirate your books. And I've spent a year making all my books. So I don't know if I trust.
Okay. And
does that make sense?
Oh, it makes perfect sense.
If I can trust it, I would, but I don't know if I mean, you know, when I spend a year making.
Yeah, and that's exactly right. And a lot of artists, I have a publisher friend in Canada that we're working with, and, you know, they're not big on doing PDFs either because of the potential of it being stolen.
Well, that's it. I mean, I don't know, but all I know is, in my head, if I put a PDF of out there, then that's out there and it can go all pirate and whatever the word is.
Right.
And then I might as well, I've not spent a year working on a book.
Okay, so the short answer is no, and you're not planning on doing
it. Yeah, the short answer is no, because
Okay, and it's absolutely nothing to apologize for, Helen, because, you know, that's exactly how a lot of artists feel, is anything potentially that it can get stolen. So that is the big issue. Yeah. All right, so My question to you, while we're taking other questions, what made you decide to do this book?
What, the sketch and shade?
Yes.
It was because when I was younger, I used to do loads of pencil graphite drawings. So I just thought I'd go back to what I did when I was a kid. I used to do loads of drawings of portraits and things. And I just thought, yeah, I'll go back and explore that. So
Okay, now did you have people talk to you and tell you that they would like to see that kind of book?
No.
No? You just decided?
It was just me.
Good. So you've been an artist, you said 30 some years of being in the field.
I'm 46 now. I've been doing art since I was, the same thing I've been wanting to do since I was like 2-3 years old. That was my
Okay, so that was your thing to do. So basically drawing and art are just one and the same for you as a person, right? I mean, they're just, it's so ingrained into you that's you live and breathe and eat artistry.
Yeah. Oh, don't get me wrong, I've done other jobs in my life. Yeah. But my passion and thing is my, done other jobs in my life.
Okay. Well, now that's an interesting question. What other kinds of jobs have you done?
I've done receptionist, sales, a mix of stuff. But
okay. I mean, I know that question's kind of throwing you a little bit, but you know, people want to know about you. You know, who is Helen Elliston? How would you describe yourself?
Mental.
Okay. Yeah, me too. But seriously,
I honestly don't know how to describe myself. I really don't. Dog lover.
Okay, dog wanner, lover, fun, energetic, loves the arts, loves to teach the arts,
yeah,
right?
Tries to cheer people up. I don't know, really.
Okay, see, there you go. Cheers people up, enjoys working with people, enjoys teaching people, especially things that are about the arts and anything that is artistically related. Now, how did you end up getting into drawing coloring books?
I just jumped on the bandwagon. It was a thing at time, and I just thought, oh, I'll give it a bit of a go.
Okay. And how long ago was that? Do you remember when you first drew your first coloring book?
I don't know. 7, 6, 7, 8 years.
Okay. And another thing that people don't know about you is that you are also an author of books that are available on Amazon. Let's talk about those a little bit.
You mean my novels?
Okay. Because I'm not sure that many people know that you have also written novels.
I haven't for years, but I did previously, yeah, wrote some about, I don't know, 5, 6, 7 adult novels.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So she wrote the adult style novels 7 or 8 years ago. Then you've gotten into coloring books and the arts, which is what you're doing now.
I've always swung between writing art. I've always swung kind of between things.
And are you writing any books now?
No, I do my art now. That's
it gives me the most pleasure, my art books and stuff, that gives me the most pleasure, and my dogs.
And your dogs, of course, of course. And let me ask you this question. Are you planning on doing more coloring books?
Well, I think my next step will be, so far what I'm thinking, if it goes down well, Sketch and Shade number 2. That's my in my head plan.
Okay, and if you were to do something like that, let's say you do decide to do that for sure, then what kind of time frame would we be talking about for a second book?
Oh God, it's 5 to 10 months.
5 to 10 months. Okay, so typically, because you said that this book here took you about a year to do.
Well, it took me from August to now, so that's kind of 10 months.
Okay, so it takes you, you said about 10 months, 8-10 months to do a book, and yeah. Have you had any indication? Yeah, so we're talking about next year, roughly, would be your next book if you did a part 2 Color and Shade.
Well, it'd be a similar time frame, unless I can learn to get up a little bit earlier.
Okay, no problem. So, in the general scheme of things, do you plan on keeping a presence in the public with some sort of book, either coloring book or another Sketch and Shade?
Yes, well, as I said, my next plan is, I've not started it yet because I've only just ended this one, Sketch and Shade, but my plan next is to do a Sketch and Shade number 2, and that's my plan at the moment. And also, I've got a friend who does, she's a florist up north, and yeah, I can use any of her, you know, floristry pictures to do drawings and things. And I want to do some floristry bouquets and things in my book. And she said I can use her, yeah, pictures. But I think people like flowers in general, don't they? But yeah, no, my plan for my next thing is Sketch and Shade number 2.
Okay, all right, so that's already kind of somewhat in the works. So do you I noticed,
and that's I will start that after after my body recovers.
So what now, what Okay, because I noticed that here when we were doing the roses, let me go back with that, because you touched on something there. Is, would you do a book just basically around flowers for people to color?
Some people have kind of thought, asked, and I don't know. I like doing a mix and eclectic and a mix.
Okay, because here's your section on
what I've always liked, like a total mix, not just flowers. And
because here's a, you know, here's your section on flowers here, and you know, this shaded part here, which I already mentioned, is like a grayscale book where people could color that. Have you thought about that?
What do you mean?
Well, this flower here looks like what somebody would publish as a grayscale image. So something like this, someone could sit down and literally color that image as a coloring book page.
Oh, I see what you mean.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, but then they can follow my steps and color it themselves.
Okay. So, okay, go ahead.
Well, because that's, you know, they can follow the steps, draw it and color it themselves. And if they want to add color to it, which, you know, if they want to, then, yeah, they can.
Because you know what? We haven't really talked about that, actually, because now I'm getting an idea. So, see? All right. So here's your final floral piece.
Yeah, with the flowy stem.
Okay. All right. So now I'm going to show you what I mean.
The only difference, Eileen,
the is what? Yeah.
If someone draws it themselves, follow my things in graphite, then obviously that's a different reaction on the thing to you drawing it on a printed page.
Right.
Do you want to explain that while I just have a wee? Do you want to explain that?
No, go ahead.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, because we're having the graphite is, you know, you've got your, it's a totally different medium.
You're going on a printed.
So what I'm doing here is showing you that in addition to teaching you how to draw the image, which is the main purpose of the book, is in some cases, if you feel so inclined, you can go ahead and color your images. So the main emphasis of the book is the drawing and teaching you how to get to this point. But if you feel like doodling a little bit,
oh, hello, babies. Yeah, no, what I was saying was, if you're drawing in graphite and then doing color over, it might be a bit more smudgy than
right.
Coloring on a grayscale book where it's a printed. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it does, but sure.
Because the printed thing won't be a smudgy.
Right. But what I was saying here. No, it makes sense. It makes perfect sense. But what I was saying here is that a little extra bonus of your book, if people so choose, is they can go ahead and color through the images. And as
yeah.
Maddie,
oh god, yeah, if you want to, yeah, definitely.
As Maddie
definitely.
Just pointed
trace them, copy them, absolutely fine. Yeah,
right.
That's the point for people to try and
that's what Maddie just pointed out is that you can go ahead is if you draw your image in graphite, which allows you the really nice effects that Helen is showing you. Then you can go ahead and copy that image with your copier, your photocopier, and then you've got a beautiful image to color.
Yeah.
So.
Because the difference is if you're drawing it to draw it in graphite pencil, you can smudge it and erase it. But if you're drawing it in order to colour it, then it's a different thing altogether.
Exactly.
I don't know, I'm explaining really badly.
So what you would recommend is, if somebody is following your book and they want to create these images to color themselves, is they should do it using the graphite pencil.
In color, then just copy it, trace it, or print it. Because if you're doing something in graphite, I can't explain it. It's too late at night.
No, it's a different animal altogether, because the graphite is a totally different look than what drawing with a simple pencil is. Now, the neat thing is, and this is what I'm showing
you
while
I'm... If you print something off, the print outline stuff stays there, doesn't it? But if you're drawing it in graphite...
Yeah. Now, what I've been able to do is, a lot of our coloring books, Helen, are grayscale coloring books, and so it looks like as though they were drawn in a graphite, you know, with a graphite pencil. And
but it's a printed version.
Right, but it's just taking the image a step further for colorists if they want. But I've been able to copy my grayscale books without any problem. In other words, the copier still carries across the image on the page. You see what I'm saying, Helen? You still have that smudged look. But
no,
what I'm showing,
I suppose, Eileen, what I was saying is, if you took a graphite pencil and drew my sunflower,
right?
Yeah. If you then added color to it, it's a totally different thing to if you photocopied it, because the ink's not going to smudge.
Right.
Whereas the graphite. Am I making sense?
Yes, you are.
Yeah.
Okay. So what I've done while we're talking, and I hope everybody can see how beautifully this is coming out, is in addition to...
And I like you've got the dint in, because that's a major thing in the sunflower. I like the center dip.
Uh-huh. So just for giggles and laughs, while we're talking to Helen, I thought it would be fun to go ahead and color this and show you how cute that image looks. All right, so now I'm going to put just a little bit of yellow in the center. And then come back with a little orange. So what we've got here, guys, is a book. Good night, Pearl. Is to show you how to do these graphite images. And then for the few images that Helen is shown completed with the graphite, if you wish, you don't have to do this, is you can go ahead and color this with a little bit of colored pencil, just for fun. Now, keeping in mind, as Helen has pointed out, that a graphite image is different. If you were just to draw it out and then color it, that's a whole different look that you're going to have. There. So see how I did that, Helen?
great, really 3D. It looks wonderful.
Yeah.
Really sunny summer. It's summer in a picture.
Yeah. So I thought that you'd get a little kick out of me doing this, Helen, on your image, just to show how that's going to come out.
Summer in a picture. Who doesn't want summer in a picture? We've all had a completely crappy year, really. So there's nothing nicer than to have a bit of a summery, cheery.
Yeah. So let me pull this in just a little bit. Now, obviously, this is not the main thrust of the book. So I'm really just doing this for fun. And it also gives you an idea that if you decide to draw your own images for your coloring pages, that this is how absolutely gorgeous something like this is going to turn out. There we go. All right. So now we've got there. There. Now we've got a nice.
That looks really golden.
Yeah. There you go.
Yeah. Golden.
Yeah. So you guys, this book will open up a whole new world to you from the standpoint of drawing with graphite images. And yes, I would go ahead, just to answer Julie's question. Yes, Julie, I would go ahead and spray that because I did color it in this page. It will not hurt the book. That's just a side issue with the Krylon, Helen, for people that decide to color on it. So.
Yeah, I've heard that on your other things before, Krylon. I've never used that, actually.
Oh, really? Yeah.
Not really aware.
I
hear that on your things a lot, Krylon.
Yeah, we use that to protect the images. And so what I would do with this, only because I decided to color in the book for fun, just for fun, on a lark, is I would spray that with my Krylon spray just to protect it so it doesn't smudge onto the next page. So that's all I was saying on that.
Good idea.
So we all learned from Helen now that she's looking to do a version 2 of this book. Yay! And that'll be fun. And let's see. I think also, Helen, have you ever sprayed a graphite picture? No? Okay. I don't see any problem with spraying a graphite picture as well, because it's just pencil. Same difference as spraying with
When I'm drawing, and I've said throughout my book, I put a blank sheet under my palm when I'm doing so to minimize smudging. But I've not done a spray thing, but you know, that's something that maybe I don't know.
Okay. Julie, for the most part, the Krylon spraying should keep it from smudging. That is the general idea of the Krylon spray to create.
But the thing is with graphite pencil, the smudging is one of my techniques.
Yes. Yes, exactly. So that is the thing, is you'd have to make absolutely sure that you're done with your image. Because once you spray it with your Krylon, you won't be able to complete that technique with the smudging.
A lot of the things in my book are pencil, smudge it, then erase a bit, then more and smudge and blob. You know, it's a mixture of take away and add. So I don't know how Krylon works with that.
Well, Helen, the Krylon spraying, in other words, I'm basically done with this image here. So I would spray it the very last thing. In other words, I wouldn't be doing anything else with it. So it would be like my final end, you know, end of addressing the image thing that I would do with that. It's just a protective spray to keep it from smudging, and especially because it is graphite pencil. So that would be the thing on there. But I would definitely
Some flower. Lovely.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I would definitely not do it.
Lovely.
Yeah.
Summery and golden.
Yeah. All right. Does anybody have any questions for Helen before we pop off? Helen, I'm just so happy that you could be here. I'm delighted. I think your book is going to be absolutely popular with everybody. And if you can go ahead, if you're going to do a version 2, that's great. And when it comes out sometime next year, if that's what you're thinking about doing, I think it would be well received.
That's my plan.
Yeah. All right, everybody. Does anybody have any questions? Oh, and by the way, Helen, several people, I'm watching the comments, several people have purchased your book. So
thank you very much.
People are purchasing it while we are talking, and that that is absolutely wonderful. All right, Helen. Thank you so much again.
I've
Helen
got to put some frozen peas on my head again before I go sleep.
Oh geez. So before we go, Helen is the author of several books. These are just a few of them that she's done. Inky Ocean, Theatrical Faces was the most recent one. We've been having fun coloring out of this book. I did a video on it. Inky Galaxy was another book that she's done, which I've done several pages out of this one as well. And then, of course, ta-da, our Sketch and Shade, which is the book that we were talking about tonight. And I hope that you guys got lots of ideas from it. And I'm absolutely delighted to be able to talk to the author of the book so she can put her input in as to what she wants you guys to get out of it. So guys, share this on your timeline. And I have put our affiliate link in so you can get it. And Helen, thank you so much for being here. We love you.
Thank you for having me, Eileen.
Well, you have a great rest of the morning, because I know it's morning
maybe
where you are.
Next time you see me, I might look a bit more normal.
Okay. All right, sweetie. You take care. Love you.
All right. I never know how to switch this off, so you'll have to switch
it off. Don't worry. I can take care of it for you. No problem. Take care. Okay. What a neat insight, guys. All right. And we've got a little bit colored out of her book. Oh. Well, I hope you guys had fun looking at that. And you can see some of the images that I drew. You know, I love having our artists come in. And don't forget too, that when I was showing you how to do the scroll, that I showed you how to add that to your image. So when you have, this is out of the Pirates book. Hope I had fun drawing. Yeah, I did. And I think I mentioned during the broadcast that even though I had the book, I made it a point not to practice with it before I went on air. I wanted you guys to see how straightforward that is to do something like that. And I'm going to find a couple of things and probably add some more scrolls to this particular page. All right. So that is Sketch and Shade. The affiliate link is both on the timeline and in the affiliate pages. It is there under S. It has been there.
Okay.
I always have so much fun when we can have an artist come in. All right. So I have been working out of Fantasy and Fairy Tale Characters by Christine Karen. And I'm pretty close. We'll see how far I am. So I have both the line art book and I've got the grayscale. There are two versions of this book and they both have slightly different covers, so you won't mix them up. So I'm going to continue with this project, and I've been doing the side by side. And I've been really enjoying this particular project. And I've been doing this all in pencil. The only exception that I did is I went ahead and used eyeshadow to go ahead and do the skin on the angel. So this one here is the grayscale. This is the line art. All righty. And if you guys feel like it, maybe post a thank you note to Helen in our group. Just tag her in it. I'm sure she'd be tickled to hear from you. Because it is, I think it's like 3 o'clock in England right now, in the UK. What time is it in the UK?
In London, England, it's 2:54 a.m.
Okay, so it's 3 o'clock in the morning for Helen. So she's been a sport about it to come in. Oh, she's had a tough week. All right. Still here getting sorted for bed. Yes, 3 o'clock in the morning, I would think so. So now I'm going to go ahead and work on this tail a little bit. Well, Helen, I'm just so glad that you braved it out with us and came on camera. Oh, Wanda, how did that work out for you? So Wanda said that she used a yellow highlighter on a coloring for the first time. So how did you, what did you do with it, Helen? Or yeah, Wanda, exactly. What was the, okay, so did you highlight the flower afterwards or beforehand? Oh, and Rhonda just got her Sharpie markers. Oh, that's great, guys. Okay, so what I'm doing now, after coloring, okay. So what I'm doing is, and this is totally up to you, Wanda, will you post that work in progress and talk about how you used your yellow highlighter? Now I'm going through and I'm tinting a little bit more. So Rhonda says that she just found out that she enjoys experimenting. All right, Rhonda, you go, girl. I love having Helen come on. She's so much fun. This tail is a little more orange than I want. So I'm going to erase that and fix it. Yeah, it's always nice to see a work in progress, guys, especially if you have something, a new technique. And that shows everybody else how you're doing something. So that's always appreciated when you do a WIP, work in progress. All right. Oh, so I was saying, if you guys would send Helen a little thank you, that would be great. I'm sure she'd appreciate it. Just post that. Okay. And remember that I told you when you're transitioning a color, zoom in. Is you don't want that color to end abruptly behind an element. So I've got the yellow coming partway down. And I'm also going to do that on my grayscale. All right, zoom out. Zoom out. So on our grayscale, you can see that we've got some shading here on the inside of the tail. So we want to go ahead and do that same type of thing. And in this case, I am going to go ahead and shade with my gray. Because that'll give me a little bit darker look than what I would normally get with just piling on another red. We've already got that gray up in the hair. I'm just going to extend it down a little bit. Zoom in. Zoom in. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to work on the flames. Flames are usually represented with yellow, orange, and red. And if you're not sure, hi, Michelle. If you're not sure how to do your flames, then go ahead and do a Google search. Good to see you, Miss Michelle. So when you've got flames going, you're pretty much going to have your yellow towards the outside. So I'm going to put my yellow on the outside, and then I'm going to come in with a little bit of orange on top of that. And this is where it's very important that you tint in your colors, like I've always taught you. And yet that yellow and orange look great, just like that. And then we're going to go ahead and peek that with my red. And if you need, just go ahead and blend that, but very, very lightly, guys. And look how cool that looks, no pun intended. All right. So let's go ahead and do the same with our flames down at the bottom. So we've got our yellow now. Hi, Sarah.
Hello.
And you can see that the minute you bring in that orange, that really makes the flame right there. And then we're going to tint that with red. And if need be, pop it over it with a yellow, but not too much, guys. Okay. Well, Sarah, from the standpoint of good triumphing over evil, I don't have a problem with it. Okay. I would not do a double image by itself, but we've got this showing, in effect, the battle between good and evil. All right. So let's put our orange in here. Now, notice I'm not coloring. Completely over the yellow. So don't get super wound up, guys, in your flames. What I said, Sarah, is from the standpoint of good triumphing over evil, I don't mind showing this image. I would not do one with just a devil image by itself. All right, so we've got the yellow. We're going to put the orange. And then we're going to add our red. And then just go ahead and do a little bit of blending. Thank you. Anybody have any questions about how to do the fire part? Zoom out. Zoom out. All right, so I highlighted the background on the left-hand side with a permanent marker. And this was on the line art portion. Now, again, I want you to see the difference between the shading. Our shading on our gray was already here. And on the line art portion, we had to add that to emulate all of this. So this is what I want you to see. And notice where it's the darker gray on this side. We have the darker red on this image. Good night, Miss Rhonda. Okay, so let's go ahead and work on the eyes. Good night, Rhonda. Good night, Rhonda. Good night, Rhonda. So glad you made it tonight. Okay, so let's go ahead and get a nice blue for the eyes. Zoom in. Zoom in. And I'm going with the darker blue on the top. And then the lighter blue on the bottom. So guys, eyes are very straightforward. So same thing here on our grayscale. Excuse me, on our line art. And then our light blue at the bottom. And then a very, very light gray on the eyeball itself, just to cut that white just a little bit. Thank you. And on the eyebrows, I'm pretty much going to leave those as is. Okay, bottom eyes. Shades of brown. Darker on top. And then our lighter on the bottom. And our light gray, just a little bit on those, on the whites. And I'm also going to hit the eyebrows with it as well. Okay. So now we can see the comparison of the two. Zoom out. Zoom out. Grayscale line art. All right, let me grab some water. And let me grab my glitter. Be right back. So I'm going to do a very simple gold and silver. Because we want that glimmering in the background. All right. Thank you. Now, a lot of people will put gold on their stars, which is perfectly fine. Zoom in. Zoom in. But I want you to think about silver. And with that silver, I'm going to mix just a little bit of purple. Not much. Look how beautiful that is. Absolutely beautiful, guys. Please do not forget your silver when you're doing stars. Zoom out. And I really hope that you guys can see how pretty this is looking now with this silver on the stars. Don't underrate this, guys. Oh, is that beautiful? zoom out. Can you guys see how that is catching the light on that twinkling? Everybody see that? And that purple, I'm only going to add to one more star. Okay. And now I'm going to go through and I'm going to dabble's not the right word, my silver onto all of my little stars. And that's going to give a really beautiful twinkling effect on this. And hopefully you'll see that as I move this. Gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous, guys. And I hope you can see how that twinkle is being caught. And these drops are pretty thick. Isn't that beautiful? So don't forget about silver against black. All right, now on this one, which is my line art, I've got way less stars. So I'm going to go ahead and place my own. Similar to what we had on the other one. Now zoom in. Like I said, I think a lot of people discount using silver as your stars. And then I'm going to have my little stars in between. And guys, so I absolutely love Stickles glitter. This other brand is working beautifully. Oh no, Maddie, turn the sound off. So can you guys see how beautifully this silver is looking as stars? Thank you. All right. Guys, absolutely beautiful. Zoom out. Zoom out. Look how that glimmers, guys. Now, if you want to go ahead and add a little bit of purple and a couple of the bigger stars, just plop that in the center. And spread it out. And then I've got one more thing that I'm going to do on these, and then I think we're going to call it done. Uh-oh, Maddie said she's fired up. All right. So let me show you this. All right. I'm going to take a little bit of our cellophane, the holographic stuff. And I'm going to dab a tiny bit of glue on the eyes. And we'll see if I can get away with this. Let's go ahead and put a little of the zoom in. Cellophane, holographic, onto the eye. All right.
Don't poke her eye out.
No, I'm not going to put red in his eyes because I don't want to emphasize it. Now, I'm using a couple layers of the holographic, and the reason that I'm doing that is because each layer, her contacts, each layer gives me a lot of depth of colors. All right. So zoom out. Okay, so this whole thing, guys, I'm calling these done. And I wanted to show you specifically grayscale line art. And I also specifically wanted to emphasize that it's a good idea to get a coloring book that has both. And that way you can practice with them and get an idea of how that's going to look. And I really hope that this has been an enjoyment for you. And that you can see the depth differences. And you can also see how they compare when you do them side by side. They're a great teaching tool. So this particular book, Fantasy and Fairy Tale Characters, does come in the line art. This one is the line art version. My grayscale one is eluding me at the moment, but they are in our affiliate list. So I hope this really gives you a good idea about how this is looking. All right, guys, I think we're good to go. Hopefully you learn something. New project tomorrow. Thank you again to Helen Ellison for showing up tonight. We had a great time with her. And we had fun seeing her book. All right, guys, this is Eileen Vick for Teaching Adult Coloring with Eileen Vick. I hope you had a good time, And I hope you learned something. All right, guys, take care. Joyous, joyous coloring, guys. You have a good rest of the evening. I will see you tomorrow night. Take care. Stay safe. Bye.